Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Angalayammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on internal combustion engine. This is lecture number 3. We are going to study about the four-stroke cycle diesel engine or four-stroke cycle combustion ignition engine. So we recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we studied about the four-stroke cycle petrol engine, the working principle, theoretical and actual PV diagram and valve timing diagram we discussed for four-stroke cycle petrol engine. Now in this lecture, so we are going to discuss in the following topics for the four-stroke cycle diesel engine, the working principle, comparison between SI and the CI engine, that is comparison between petrol and the diesel engine, theoretical and actual PV diagram of the four-stroke cycle diesel engine and the valve timing diagram of four-stroke cycle diesel engine. So, learning outcome to the learners, to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to discuss the working of four-stroke cycle diesel engine, the student will be able to compare the petrol and the diesel engine, and the student will be able to distinguish between theoretical and actual PV diagram. And the student will be able to draw the theoretical and actual valve timing diagram, and they will be able to discuss or define valve overlap and write its significance. You take few seconds time and look at the video. So this is four stroke cycle compression ignition engine or diesel engine. So you may find the piston is reciprocating and the inlet valve with the blue color line, inlet valve opens at a certain time. There is fuel injection and the exhaust valve opens and the exhaust gas has sent to the atmosphere. So the first stage air intake, second is compression, third is fuel injection and combustion, and fourth is exhaust. Now the suction, compression, combustion, exhaust. So the process is continued. So there are four cycles: compression, suction stroke, compression stroke, expansion stroke, and the exhaust stroke. And we'll see the detailed diagram here. So the intake stroke, compression stroke, power stroke, and the exhaust. So for the intake stroke, look at here, the piston is moving downward from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. The inlet intake valve is open and the fresh air, so here it is only air, fresh air is drawn into the engine cylinder due to the pressure difference, and the piston reaches the bottom dead center at the end of the process. Now for the compression, the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. Look at the valves, both the valves are closed. The air is compressed inside the cylinder to a higher pressure. So pressure at the end of the compression process is very high, higher than the petrol engine. And at the end of the compression process, using the fuel injector, so a small quantity of fuel is injected. So using the temperature of the air, so at the end of the compression, there is increase in temperature of the air. So, using the temperature of the air, the fuel starts to burn and it produces heat. So, because of the heat, the pressure and temperature of the gases are increasing and the piston is pushed. The gas pressure is acting on the top of the piston and the piston is moving towards the bottom dead center. So, that is the power stroke or the expansion stroke. Then, at the end of the power stroke, we have only the hot gases, burnt gases inside the engine cylinder. In the fourth stroke, the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center and this exhaust valve opens and the burnt waste gases are led to the atmosphere. So, intake, compression, power and exhaust, these are all the four strokes. So, we'll discuss the working of the four strokes with the help of a table. So, suction stroke, compression stroke, expansion stroke and the exhaust stroke. So, for the suction stroke, suction valve opens, exhaust valve closed. Piston is moving from the TDC to BDC, air through the air filter is drawn into the engine cylinder due to the pressure difference. So when the piston is moving downward, the pressure inside the cylinder is less than the surrounding pressure, atmospheric pressure. So the atmospheric air is drawn inside through the air filter, and in the next stroke, compression stroke, both inlet and the exhaust valves are closed. The piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. The air is compressed to a higher pressure. So at the end of the process, diesel is injected at the end of the stroke. The compression of the fuel begins using the temperature of the air. And the third stroke, expansion stroke, both valves are closed. The piston is moving from the TDC to BDC. The gas pressure is acting on the top of the piston. The piston is moving towards the bottom dead center. The hot gases produced by combustion expands in the cylinder, and the power is produced. Then the fourth stroke, exhaust stroke, the suction valve is closed, exhaust valve opens, and the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. So the burnt gases are led to the atmosphere due to the pressure difference once again. Now the pressure inside the cylinder is higher than the pressure of the atmosphere. So the burnt gases or the waste gases are pushed to the atmosphere. Now this is the working of the four-stroke cycle diesel engine. Now we take the comparison. Already we studied the four-stroke cycle petrol engine and four-stroke cycle diesel engine. Now we compare the four-stroke cycle petrol engine and diesel engine with respect to different points of comparison. First point of comparison is basic cycle of operation. SI engine is operating on constant volume cycle or auto cycle. Auto cycle we studied earlier in the gas power cycle. So in the auto cycle, the constant volume heat addition cycle. So that is the basic cycle for SI engine. Whereas for the CI engine, diesel cycle or constant pressure heat addition cycle. So in the diesel cycle, the pressure is, heat is added to constant pressure. So the fuel used in the SI engine, gasoline, a high volatile fuel, and the self ignition is, ignition temperature is higher. So that is why we require a spark. So self ignition temperature is high, so we require a spark to initiate the combustion. High volatile fuel means it will easily evaporate. So the volatility of the fuel is very high. In the case of diesel engine, diesel oil, so it is a non-volatile fuel. So it will not, actually the volatility of the diesel is very less. So the self ignition temperature is comparatively low. So that is why, and using the temperature of the compressed air, it starts burning. So the self ignition temperature is low for the diesel engine, diesel fuel. So with respect to load control, so SI engine are quality controlled. That means the richness or of the amount of fuel in the mixer is controlled using the throttle valve. So in the carburetor, so throttle control the quality of mixer introduced in the engine cylinder. In the case of CI engine, the quantity of fuel regulated by the pump. So we have the injector and the fuel pump. So the fuel pump regulates the amount of fuel injected at the end of the stroke. Air quantity is not controlled. So we control only the amount of fuel supplied, fuel injected in the engine cylinder. And based on the speed of the engine, so SI engine, due to its weight, and the weight is low weight, and also due to homogeneous combustion, they are high speed engine. So SI engine, petrol engines are high speed engine, and diesel engine due to the heavy weight. So CI engine are heavy, heavy weight engine, and also due to the heterogeneous combustion, they are low speed engine. So comparatively, CI engines are low speed engine and petrol engines are high speed engine. That is why we, in the race cars, race bike, we are using only the petrol engine. And based on the compression ratio, SI engine, the compression ratio is between 6 and 10. The upper limit is fixed by the anti-knock quality of the fuel. So for auto cycle or the petrol engine, the compression ratio is within 10, 6 to 10. In the case of CI engine, the compression ratio is 16 to 20. The upper limit is fixed based on the weight of the engine. So increasing the compression ratio will increase the weight of the engine. So the upper limit is based on the weight of the engine. The weight. So SI engine are lighter due to the low peak pressure. So The SI engine compression ratio is less. At the end of the compression, the pressure is also less. The peak pressure is less. So, it is light in weight. Whereas, in the case of CI engine or diesel engine, so they are heavier due to the higher pressure inside the engine cylinder. So, thermal efficiency, it is low in the case of petrol engine because of low compression ratio. So, low compression ratio, low efficiency. And in the case of CI engine, compression ratio is higher, so the efficiency is higher in the case of diesel engine. So, for the same size and the power, the petrol engine efficiency is lower than the diesel engine efficiency. And the introduction of fuel, in the case of petrol engine, a gaseous mixture of fuel and air is introduced during the suction stroke. A carburetor is necessary to provide the mixer. So, carburetor is fitted with the petrol engine to prepare the air fuel mixer. In the case of CI engine or the diesel engine, fuel is injected directly into the compression chamber at a high pressure at the end of the compressor stroke. A fuel pump and injectors are necessary for injecting the quantity of the fuel. So, these are all the points of comparison between petrol and the diesel engine. So, basic cycle, the type of fuel, type of load control, the type of the speed and compression ratio, weight of the engine, thermal efficiency and introduction of the fuel. So, you have to understand the points, important points, particularly thermal efficiency, weight of the vehicle and speed control, the load control, everything you have to understand. So, sometimes they may ask in the objective questions. Then, theoretical and actual PV diagram of four-stroke cycle diesel engine. So, we will look at the PV diagram. This is the diesel cycle. So, the 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5 and 5 to 1. So, 0 to 1. So, the piston is moving backward. So, from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. So, at the constant pressure, the suction process is taking place. So, 0 to 1 is suction process. 1 to 2 is the compression process. So, 1 to 2 is the compression and 2 to 3 is the constant pressure combustion. So, in the case of diesel engine, the pressure diesel cycle, the combustion or heat addition is at constant pressure and then the 3 to 4 is expansion, isentropic expansion, PV to the power gamma equal to constant and the 4 to 5, it is called as when the piston is at the point 4, when the piston is here at the bottom dead center, the exhaust valve opens. Once the exhaust valve opens, there is sudden pressure drop from 4 to 5, that is called as blow down operation. And once the pressure drops, then the using the piston movement, we can push the exhaust gases outside. So, 5 to 0 is exhaust. So, 0 to 1 suction, 1 to 2 compression, 2 to 3 combustion, 3 to 4 expansion, 4 to 5 blow down and 5 to 0 exhaust. And this is the actual PV diagram which is drawn using the indicator, the instrument called indicator, where the input required for drawing this diagram is the cylinder pressure and the crank angle. So, the crank angle sensor is provided, the input from the crank angle sensor is provided and the pressure measured with the help of pressure sensor, that is also given to the indicator as an input. Using the two inputs, so it will plot the PV diagram. So, look at the deviation. So, 0 to 1, we said the earlier suction process. Now, 1 to 2 is the suction process. So, during the suction process, the pressure inside the engine cylinder is slightly lower than the atmospheric pressure. Then only the air will enter into the cylinder. And 2 to 3 is the compression process. So, compression process. And 3 is the start of the fuel injection. And 4 is the 3 to 4 is the fuel injection and the compression process. And 4 to 5, the expansion process and expansion continues, but before it, here if the exhaust valve opens, so there is a sudden drop in the pressure. Then the exhaust, so the 5 to 1 is the exhaust operation. So, this is the actual PV diagram for the 4-stroke cycle diesel engine. And the entire PV diagram is explained with the help of a table here. So, suction stroke 0 to 1, compressor stroke 1 to 2, expansion stroke 3 to 4 and exhaust stroke 5 to 0. So, we draw the valve suction stroke, inlet valve is opened, exhaust valve is closed, piston moves from the TDC to BDC, the air is drawn into the engine cylinder at constant pressure. Compression stroke, both the valves are closed. Piston moves from BDC to TDC, the air is compressed isentropically. At the end of the compression process, the fuel is injected and it is ignited using the high temperature at the end of compression stroke. The combustion takes place at constant pressure 2 to 3. Then 3 to 4 expansion stroke, both the valves are closed. Piston moves from TDC to BDC. The hot gases produced by the combustion pushes the piston towards the bottom dead center and the work is obtained in this stroke. That is, this is also called as power stroke. And finally, we have the exhaust stroke 5 to 0. The inlet valve is open, inlet valve is closed, exhaust valve is open. The piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. When the exhaust valve opens, the pressure inside the cylinder drops as shown in the figure 4 to 5 or 4 to 1. Then the waste gases are exhausted to the atmosphere at the constant pressure. This is the blow down and the exhaust. So these are all the operations of the PV, the details of the PV diagram, what we have seen here. So, the PV diagram and the corresponding operations, various operations. And finally, we will draw the theoretical valve timing diagram of 4-stroke cycle diesel engine, and we will discuss the actual valve timing diagram. So, look at the diagram. The 4 strokes are completed in 2 revolutions of the crankshaft. So, the piston starts from the top dead center. So, look at the diagram. This is the top dead center. This is the bottom dead center. And the inlet valve opens when the piston is at the top dead center. The piston is moving towards the bottom dead center. So, the operation is called a suction operation. At the end of the suction, when the piston reaches the bottom dead center, the inlet valve is closed. Then the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. So, the operation is called as compression. And at the end of the compression, when the piston is at the top dead center, the fuel is injected. So, small quantity of fuel is injected. Then, the combustion takes place at constant pressure. Now, the piston is moving from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. And this operation is called as expansion. And then, when the piston is at the bottom dead center, the exhaust valve opens. And now, the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. And the burnt gases are sent to the atmosphere, that is called as exhaust operation. And here, all the valve opening, valve closing exactly occurring at the top dead center. This is theoretical. But in practice, so we see the diagram, all the valve opening and valve closing are exactly at the bottom dead center or the top dead center. This is only theoretical, but actually this is deviating. So, inlet valve opens, closes, not exactly at the top dead center, the bottom dead center in the actual engine. So, the actual PV, the actual valve timing diagram of the 4-stroke cycle diesel engine is shown here. And in the previous diagram, we said inlet valve opens exactly at the top dead center, but here it is some 25 degree before the top dead center. So, inlet valve opens here. So, why the inlet valve opens, we will see, I will tell you at the end. So, inlet valve opens here, the air starts to enter into the engine cylinder. So, the green color line is the suction. Now, the piston is moving from the TDC to BDC and it goes up to 25 degree after the bottom dead center. So, 25 degree before the top dead center and 25 degree after the bottom dead center, the inlet valve closes only here. Then, once the inlet valve is closed, so this black color line is the compression process. So, black color line is compression process, the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center and the compression it goes, and here the 5 degree prior to the top dead center, the fuel starts FIS, that is fuel injection starts. So, earlier we said, theoretical cycle we said, the fuel is injected exactly at the top dead center, but it is 5 degree prior to the top dead center, and the fuel injection continues for 15 degree after the top dead center. So, fuel engine closes here, more than 15 degree. So, this is somewhere around 25 degree. So, 5 degree before TDC and 25 degree after TDC, the fuel injection occurs. So, a crank angle of roughly 30 degree. Now, once the fuel is injected, so immediately it is prepared in the air fuel mixer and then combustion starts. So combustion starts, the gas temperature increases and burning continues. So the gas is expanding. So when the piston is started to move from the top dead center, this operation is called as expansion and power is produced. So before the piston reaches the bottom dead center, so here the exhaust valve opens. But earlier theoretical diagram, exhaust valve opens only at the bottom dead center. Now it is opening some 50 degree, maximum 50 degree before the bottom dead center, and the exhaust process starts. So the burnt gases, as the piston is moving from the bottom dead center to the top dead center, the exhaust, the burnt gases are sent to the atmosphere, and now the burnt gases, it is open only, the exhaust valve open only at 15 degree after the top dead center. So the process, actually the exhaust process continues after the top dead center up to 15 degree. Now you look at the deviation, inlet valve opens prior to the top dead center to 25 degree, inlet valve closes after the bottom dead center 25 degree, fuel injection starts 5 degree prior to the TDC and 25 degree after the TDC, exhaust valve opens 50 degree before the bottom dead center and the exhaust valve closes 15 degree after the top dead center. So why there is a deviation? We take the inlet valve. For inlet valve, so starting from inlet valve opening, when the piston reaches the top dead center, the inlet valve should be in the complete opening position. So instantaneously we cannot open the valve completely, full opening is not achieved instantaneously. So the valves are slowly, the mechanical system, the valves are slowly opening. So we start early, so 25 degree early, we start the opening early. When the piston reaches the top dead center, you may find the inlet valve is completely open. So that is why we are advancing the opening of the inlet valve. Then similarly in the closing, so 25 degree after the bottom dead center. So when this piston is at the bottom dead center, the inlet valve starts to close. So starting to close, when the piston after 25 degree, here it is completely closed. Inlet valve is completely closed. Similarly for fuel injection, it is not spontaneous, it is not instantaneous at the top dead center. So we require a duration. So we require certain quantity of fuel injection, small time duration for injecting the fuel, that is why it is 5 degree before the TDC and 25 degree after the TDC. Similarly, exhaust valve. So for exhaust valve opens 50 degree. So when the piston is coming to the bottom dead center, the exhaust valve should be completely in open position and the burnt gases should be sent out. So the exhaust gas should be completely sent out from the engine cylinder. Then only we can get the better efficiency of the engine. So that is why we are opening earlier and it is closed earlier. So when the piston is reaching the top dead center, the exhaust valve starts to close, but it is completely closed 15 degree after the top dead center. So that is actually, we require mechanical system to operate, actuate the valves, we require certain time. So it is gradually opening and closing. That is why we are advancing or delaying the opening or closing of the valves. And when you look at the diagram, so here, as in the case of petrol engine, so both the valves, inlet valve and exhaust valve, they are kept open for certain duration. So 25 degree before TDC and 15 degree after TDC. So nearly 40 degree crank angle, both the valves are kept open, and that period is called as valve overlapping period. So the valve overlapping period is essential and it should be optimized. The valve overlapping period should be carefully designed to avoid the escape of fresh air entering into the cylinder to leave the engine cylinder. So we have to design the engine cylinder carefully for the valve overlap period. So we stop here and we have some questions to answer from the lecture. First question, four operations, namely suction, compression, expansion, exhaust in a four-stroke cycle are completed in the number of revolutions of the crankshaft equal to 1 revolution, 2 revolution, 3 revolution, 4 revolution. You quickly answer the question. So if your answer is 2, you are correct. The four operations, namely suction, compression, expansion, exhaust in a four-stroke cycle are completed in the number of revolutions of the camshaft equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. The answers are 1, 2, 3, 4. quickly answer to the question. So if your answer is 1, you are correct, because the camshaft is rotating half the speed of the crankshaft. That is, when the crankshaft rotates 2 times, 2 revolutions, and the camshaft will rotate 1 revolution. In a 4-stroke cycle diesel engine, during suction stroke, only air is sucked in, only fuel is sucked in, mixture of fuel and air is sucked in, and none of the above. So, right, you quickly select the answer. So, if your answer is 1, only air is sucked in, you are correct. Speed of petrol engine is less than the diesel engine, whether this is higher or lower. So, if your answer is higher, you are correct. Speed of the petrol engine is higher than the diesel engine. Efficiency of petrol engine is less than the diesel engine, higher or lower. So, efficiency of the petrol engine is lower than the diesel engine. If your answer is lower, you are correct. So, we stop here. So, these are all the reference books I used for preparing the slides. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it. Other books are Internal Combustion Engine by Ganesan, Gildensmith, John B. Haywood, Thermal Engineering by Rajput or Balani. So, you can refer to it for additional information. So, thank you for watching. So, please post comments on the comment box in the YouTube video. So, after listening to the video, immediately you please click the comment box and post your comments. Subscribe the channel. I have uploaded more than 160 video lectures on thermal engineering subjects, and the gate questions are solved and uploaded. So, it will be useful for your better learning. You can write to my mail ID for any queries or WhatsApp to my number. I will sincerely answer to all your queries. So, thank you for watching again. So, we'll meet again.